Voilà. Without further ado, here we go. Buying private real estate in Belgium, how to finance and insure, what about taxation, and of course, tips and tricks. The menu of my presentation is as follows. A very short introduction to your tax status, some real estate market information, always good to have, then a chunk on financing and insurance, real estate taxation, the timeline and prerequisites of buying property in Belgium, not uninteresting because there are a few special items for expats, where to seek advice, and then for those that are not looking to buy property just to live in, but as an investment, a few tips and tricks at the end. Now, your tax status. Now, either you are a fiscal resident or a fiscal non-resident in Belgium. If you have the special expat tax status of the circular of 1983, well, then you are considered a fiscal non-resident in Belgium, although you live here day by day. Similar situation with international civil servants, like of the EU or NATO. So it's very good and important that you know what your status is. It's also good to know what your tax status is in your home country. But we're talking about real estate here. And concerning real estate, the taxation of income from real estate typically follows the situs principle, which simply means that there is taxation in the country where the real estate is located. Since we are talking about purchase of real estate in Belgium, that means that this is taxable in Belgium. It may also be taxable in your country of residence if that's another country, but it will be limited. Do pay attention that your residency or non-residency in Belgium for inheritance tax may be different from the above. Now, some real estate market information to start with. First, Belgium in general, there is no private real estate bubble in Belgium. Prices, when compared to other countries, are not that high. Brussels is another story, but I'll come to that in a second. Still, the economic prospects are not very clear, but interest rates are rock bottom low. 1 to 2%, depending on the tenor and your personal situation. Real estate also has financial attractiveness as a long-term investment. So if you are thinking of buying real estate, that could very well become a good investment. The Belgian market has seen its little bubbles over the past decades, but still on the real estate side, it is typically less bubble prone than other countries like US, UK, Spain, the Netherlands. Coming to Brussels, Brussels is of course rather expensive in Belgium, if you compare with other areas of Belgium, but it's still rather cheap in the world. It depends of course with what you compare. If you compare with Paris and London, well then it's cheap, yes. But it always depends on your city or country of reference. Brussels of course has the influence of the likes of the European Union, NATO, which leads to an important influx of new civil servants or people working in the embassies, and even business people and lobbyists around the European Union. We'll have to see, of course, whether or not Brexit will have an impact, yes or no. Last but not least, to be checked whether there is not a bit of over-anticipation by real estate developers, meaning that there may be quite a bit of opportunities on the market. Although we've seen with COVID-19 that prices are stable and the goods get sold at a decent pace. Just for your information, there is a very interesting Eurostat house price index. If you type this Eurostat house price index in your Google search engine or any other search engine, you will come to Eurostat and you will find information for all European countries and over many, many years. So I recommend you to do that. Last point on real estate market information, what can be the conclusion, at least for Brussels, is that obviously good quality property, not too exclusive in a good location, should be fine. A good quality 1 to 2 bedroom apartment at 45 minutes max from the Schumann roundabout or Luxembourg Square should do reasonably well. However, recently there is more focus on the new areas of Brussels. Jet, Forêt, Anderlecht, Schaarbeek, brand new or refurbished, and not to mention the canal region. And of course, there are also new ways of living together, young and old, shared common facilities, what have you. And to be seen what the impact of the new normal post-COVID-19 will be. People are working more and more from home, so they need an office at home. And if they work more and more at home, the commuting time is less important because there is less commuting. And things like a garden or a big balcony become more important. Last but not least, a few general points of attention. Not all new expats are as rich as the old expats. I'm into this business since many years. I have quite a bit of gray hair in the meantime. But 20 years ago, you had expats coming on incredible packages that could sometimes afford a villa with a pool in Uccle. In Uccle, that is not always the case anymore. Unemployment is also reasonably high in the Brussels region. So if you're looking to buy to let, and you're also looking at the local population as tenants, keep that in mind. And economic migrants do not always bring savings immediately, so rents in Belgium are not always very high. Luckily, interest rates are very low. Of course, I don't have a crystal ball, but generally it's expected that they will stay low for one or a few more years. Okay, financing and insurance. First of all, a little bit of information on mortgage credit formulas in Belgium. Typically, you can have interest rate systems whereby every year your interest rate is reviewed. Then you have typically the lowest possible interest rate. You also have 5-yearly review of your interest rate. Then the interest rate will be a little bit higher. And you can also go for a fixed interest rate, and that's typically the highest interest rate of the three types. On the repayment side of mortgage credit, the most typical system in Belgium is constant monthly repayments, meaning that every month you repay the same amount of money. There are other schemes like constant capital repayments, meaning that every month you repay the same amount of capital and your interest fluctuates in function of the outstanding capital. And you also sometimes have interest-only mortgage credits or bullet credits, meaning that you do not repay capital during the whole period of the loan or credit, the tenor, as it's being called, but you pay everything back in full at the end. But then the interest rate is higher than for constant monthly repayments, for example. Credit to house value. The days of 10 years ago, where you could borrow 100% or 110% sometimes of the value of a property are behind us since a few years now. Today, it's typically 90% of the value of the property that you can borrow. On the mortgage credit side, the guarantee side, better said, banks will at least want a full-blown mortgage on part of your loan or credit, and a mandate or a power to give mortgage on the other part. Insurances. Banks will like you to take out a debt balance insurance. It's a life insurance guaranteeing the repayment of the loan if you would pass away. And banks will like you to take at least a fire insurance. And you can add civil liability and theft and what have you to that. Real estate taxation. And this is an important subject, particularly since in Belgium, taxes on purchase are very high. And so if you buy property in Belgium, the cost is very high. And the cost is especially high, let's start with the second bullet point, if you buy a brand new building. Because then there is 21% VAT on the price of the property. If there is also land involved, on the land, there is only 12.5%. Excuse me. Now, if you buy a second-hand property, if I may call it that way, then the taxation on purchase is lower. In the Brussels capital region, it's even pretty low if it concerns your only own home. Worldwide. So if you buy your only own home in Brussels capital region and the price of the property is less than 500,000 euros, you do not pay tax on the first 175,000 euros of the value of the property. Let's take a simple example, at least for me. If you buy an apartment of 275,000 euros, then, and it's your only own home worldwide, then on the first 175,000 euros, you pay nothing. But on the remainder, 100,000 euros in my example, you pay 12.5%. And 12.5% on 100,000 euros is 12,500 euros. Of course, do not forget to add the notary costs and the mortgage costs. The real estate purchase tax is regionalized, so it's the system is different region by region. In Flanders, if it's your only own home, you will typically pay 6% and you have a small abattement or reduction. In Wallonia, there is typically under conditions reduced rate for the first 160,000 euros of the value of the property. But remember, if you buy a new, brand new property, there is 21% VAT, and that can be expensive. And then there are other costs, like the notary and the mortgage costs. But on the website notaire.be or notaris.be, you can calculate those costs. Now, until 5 to 10 years ago, the taxation of a mortgage credit in Belgium was pretty favorable. But now, as the purchase tax has been reduced and the abattements, the reductions in purchase tax have been increased, there is only Wallonia that still has a fiscal advantage on the mortgage itself. They call it chèque habitation, but it should be for your a purchase of property for your only own home. If you are a non-resident in Belgium, this applies too, but you need to have enough taxable income in Belgium. Taxation of the capital gain. The capital gain on real estate in Belgium, and we are talking about private real estate here, and we are talking about the purchase of private real estate as a private person, and not not as a company, then for buildings, if you keep the property for at least 5 years, then there is no tax on the capital gain. So imagine you buy property at 200,000 euros after 10 years. Let's take an easy example. You sell for 300,000 euros, you have a capital gain of 100,000 euros, at least gross, and that is not taxable because there is 10 years between purchase and sale. For land, you need to calculate 8 years. Now, the good news is that if you buy property as your only own home, and you have to sell it to buy another only own home, then it's very rare in Belgium that you pay any tax on the capital gain. Taxation of the real estate income. Now, there is something called real estate withholding tax in Belgium. It varies with the region, the province, and the commune where the property is located. And is based on what is called the revenu cadastral, cadastral inkomen. In English, I typically call it the fiscal yearly rent value. It's much lower than the real rent value, I can tell you. And when the property concerns your only own home, where you actually live, then the real estate withholding tax should be the only taxation. To give you a very rough idea, because it depends on the region, the province, and the commune, and the size of the property, and the location, and what have you, and the quality, and so on and so forth, I would say that typically the range is between 500 and 3,000 euros per year. For 3,000 euros, you of course have a small castle, but 500 euros for a small apartment. But this is just an indication. It depends on the region, on the province, and the commune. Now, when you buy to let, when you are renting to a private person for private use, then actually taxation is still very low, but there is an increase of 40% of the revenu cadastral. You have to pay attention when you rent your property out to a company or to an individual using the property for professional use, because then the taxable base is the real rent income, not this fiscal yearly rent value, the revenu cadastral, but the real rent value. Still, you can deduct part of that income with costs that you have. So the real rent income minus up to 40% is the taxable base. We are quickly a few estate planning considerations. If you are considered a resident for estate planning, for succession, for inheritance matters in Belgium, then the heirs of residents typically pay taxes on the net value of the real estate. I explain myself, the net value means that the mortgage or the outstanding balance of the mortgage is deducted from the value of the property before taxation. If you are a non-resident, you have to pay attention if you come from outside the European Economic Area, because then in Flanders and Brussels, you may be taxed on the gross value. In Wallonia, even the people resident outside of the European Economic Area are treated like residents. Attention, inheritance tax matters are not regulated by the regular double taxation income treaties, and Belgium only has two treaties for estate planning, and that's with France and Sweden. Okay, without further ado, a few tips and tricks. First of all, what is the typical timeline to buy private property in Belgium? Many people ask me this. And the first step you have to take is to calculate your borrowing capacity. And you could do that, for example, on the ing.be website. You calculate your borrowing capacity, you get an amount, then you add your savings, you deduct the taxes, and you deduct the notary costs and the mortgage costs, and then you get your budget. And this is key before going to search on the real estate market. And of course, you can do it yourself, but you can also go to a real estate agent and ask him or her to help you find an appropriate property for your budget. Then we think it's good to not just list one potential target, because if it's getting sold before your eyes, then you will feel very bad. And it's better to have a few potential targets in mind. It's important to visit them, because pictures may be very different than the reality. And then you want to know who the neighbors are, you want to see the streets, you want to see the light through the windows, and so on and so forth. It's also highly recommended to have a real estate expert value the property before buying. Okay, it costs a few hundred euros, but at least you will have certainty about the state of the property. Is this property in a decent state? And you will have a price reference. Maybe you have no problem in paying 5% more than what the price reference from the expert is. But if his or her price is only half of what you are asked to pay, then you should negotiate or walk away. When you reach a kind of an agreement, not in writing, but you feel that the time is there to sign a pre-sales agreement, then it's very important to choose a notary. And don't worry, if the seller already has a notary, if you choose your own notary, that doesn't cost anything extra. The two notaries then have to split the legal notary fees. Notary fees in Belgium are legally fixed. I mean, you can't negotiate. It's very important in that pre-sales agreement to have all the typical suspensive conditions included. The most important one from the banking side is that you make that offer that you are ready to buy, subject to obtaining adequate bank financing. Because imagine that there is no bank around that wants to give you a mortgage credit. Hey, then you will be forced to still pay the 5 or 10% down payment that you have to pay at the signing of the pre-sales agreement. And nobody wants to pay 5 to 10% for nothing. Point four is, of course, to formally ask for a mortgage credit. Please take into consideration that even if you have all the paperwork ready, that it takes typically 2 weeks to get a yes or a no. Don't forget about that. Within 4 months after the pre-sales agreement, the notary will draw up the formal sales agreement for signature and payment. But there are other things to look out for as an expat in Belgium. It's very important that you take note of the fact that banks will typically want you to have a kind of a permanent residency card in Belgium already. If you come from the European Union, that typically never is an issue. But if you come from outside the European Union, it may be an issue. So double check with your bank before going into the market. Of course, banks will want your payslips and see maybe your employment contract. But that's a general condition. A condition that is important to know for expats, again, is that your regular income should be paid in euro. Especially for US nationals, for example, if you live and work here, but your income is paid in US dollars, sadly, we can't help you. And to my understanding, there are no or very few financial institutions that can help if regular income is not paid in euro. And then you have the typical things that Belgian banks typically do not want you to use more than one third of your regular income to repay your debts. And I repeat that a mortgage credit can be obtained subject to formal credit approval, of course, for maximum 90% of the value of the property. And if it's buy to let, it's even only 80%. So for the buy to let people in the room, take that into consideration. Voilà. We're nearing the slowly but surely the end of my formal presentation, where to seek advice for licensed real estate agents. We of course have Catherine Viane of NOA Real Estate in this event, in the Expat Financial Affairs tonight, but there are others, and you can have a look at ep.be or biv.be to find them. Same for a Belgian notary. We of course have a notary of Berkane Notaries with us today, but there are others, and you can find them via notaire.be or notaris.be. And then a bank or a mortgage broker, ING, for example. But as you all know, there are other banks around, and there are also mortgage brokers. Online, there are interesting websites like ImmoWeb, for example, that you can use to find a property, especially if you are in the do-it-yourself mode. And then, of course, friends and other expats or expats group in person or via social media may give you a lot of tips and tricks. And also free real estate information seminars or webinars as the one we are having right now. As the cherry on the cake, two slides for the people in the virtual room that want to invest in private real estate. Now, first of all, if you want to invest in private real estate, there are a few options. People typically think that the only way to invest in private real estate is to buy a house or an apartment and to rent it out. That's only one option. And it has its advantages, but also its disadvantages. If you do a direct investment in private real estate, you know what you own, but still rent yields are rather low in Belgium. It's a very illiquid investment. I mean, you can't sell it overnight. It takes, you've seen it in the process I've described, it may take 4 months. It may be reasonably costly. There is also no diversification. You put 250,000 euros in an apartment. That's not diversified. That's just one asset. Alternatively, you can buy a stock exchange listed company that itself invests in private real estate. So you buy a company on the stock exchange and that company invests in several real estate assets. And then you don't have to do the management of the property. You have a decent diversification because this company is not investing in one property typically. You have a liquid investment. You can sell fund. You have more estate planning options, meaning it's easier to give this investment to your next of kin than it is for bricks and mortar. Similar to buying a stock exchange listed company, you can also buy a mutual fund that itself invests in private real estate. That's quite similar. Then very last point on buy to let is that, of course, you do not have to buy as a private person. You can also buy via a company. And that can also be a foreign company. No issues there. But of course, both have their advantages. If you buy as a private person, I've explained that the taxation of the rent is low if you rent out to a private person for private use, and that there is no taxation on capital gains if you keep at least 5 years and for land 8 years. And in Flanders, if you buy in Flanders region, or better said, if you are a resident in Flanders region, there are separate rates for real estate assets and for financial assets. But if you buy via a company, there are advantages too. Via a company, you can depreciate the building and the renovation. You can you have more possibilities to deduct costs, and you can deduct interest charges in full. And you can do estate planning, easy estate planning through gifts to your next of kin, for example. You have limited responsibility because it's in a company. So keep all of that in mind. One slide with some contact details at ING Belgium and our little new logo. But I